hopefully. So we have this one with us. I spent four times. So again, 27 plus 12, 29, 24. 24 will be third test.
24?
Okay. And 26 will be your final.
Okay.
And you guys have a final May 3rd.
May 3rd?
Yeah. Good, good.
Good, good, good.
Okay, let's do this. So tangent plan. By the way, 24 is the third test, okay? The final will be May 3rd. The tangent plan. It's given by partial derivative x minus x star at p plus partial derivative y at p y minus y dot plus partial derivative of g at p g minus g dot is given by zero. In other words, gradient of f p at p dot with the vector x minus y x minus x dot, y minus y dot, g minus g dot is equal to zero equals tangent plane. So example of the tangent plane is given by, let's say example one in here. So we have to find the tangent plane. F of x, y, and g is given by x squared plus y squared plus g minus 9 is equal to 0. So let's get it. Tangent plane. Tangent plane is not that hard. Okay? Again, we have to find the gradient first, right? Gradient of f is given by 2x, 2y, and 1, right? That's my gradient. And we plug in our point P in the gradient. The gradient of f, f 1, 2, 4 will be given by 2, 4, and 1. This is my gradient. Mm-hmm. So my x dot, y dot, g dot is equal to 1, 2, 4. So again, I'm going to plug in this one to here. So my tangent plane now will be given by 2 times x minus my x dot 1, 4 times y minus 2, plus 1 times g minus 4 is equal to 0. This is my tangent plan. How was it? Good? So let's do another one, another example. So the important thing in this case, we have to know what x dot y dot g dot is, and also what we have to know, the gradient. So we just take a dot product, and it will be my tangent plane. Example number two. Find the tangent plane again. And finish this one, and finish this one, and finish this one. Not here the extension, I'm just double integral. Good. So we can make it. We can make it on time. Don't worry. So let's do this part now. So we have to look at my f function first. So f, let's move g to the left and right hand side, and it'd be equal to
zero. Is that x
of
y r?
Which one?
The first one.
This one?
Yeah, is that a r?
This is g.
Oh, g.
Well, this one is off. Find the tangent plane off. No, example number two. At
0, 0, 0.
At z.
This one?
No, z.
G.
The before z.
X cosine y.
Before.
This is O.
Oh, okay.
So let's do this.
Okay.
So again, tangent plane, why it takes a long time by the way? Tangent plane, again, we have to find the gradient at a given point, right?
Okay.
So let's get gradient. Let's find f. F will be x cosine y minus y into the x minus g is equal to zero. That's my f function. So let's get a gradient. So gradient of f will be cosine y minus y into the x, comma, and minus x sine y minus e to the x, comma, minus 1. This is my gradient. Now let's evaluate this one at 0, comma, 0, comma, 0. So gradient over at the point 0, comma, 0, comma, 0 will be cosine 0 minus 0, comma, 0 minus e to the 0, comma, minus 1. In other words, cosine 0 is 1, 1, comma, this is minus 1, and minus 1. This is my gradient of f. And x equal to 0, y equal to 0, g equal to 0. I just plug it to gradient. So tangent plane, now it's pretty easy. One times x minus 0, minus 1 times y minus 0, minus 1 times g minus 0 is equal to 0. Because we have x dot 0, y dot 0, g dot 0. Then simplify, we have x minus y minus g is equal to 0. This is my tangent. Method is pretty easy. Find gradient. Then each gradient multiply x minus x dot, y minus y dot. Question. Is that okay? Yeah. Minus tangent plane. Okay. So let's move to differentials. We call estimating change in a specific direction. So it means estimate how much the variable function f change if we move small distance that's called ds from a point P dot to another point. You can easily find df. How much they change, we call df, which kind of a differential in care 1 will be given by f prime at original point p dot times ds So this one was a differential derivative, but here will be given by gradient of f at p dot times u vectors dx. Because we have a specific directions, right? So we use directional derivative for this derivative. You guys know what this one is, right?
Derivative with respect to s, what's s?
Okay, you guys remember or don't remember? So y equal to f of x, what's the differentials? I'd like to measure how y changes when x changes. This is we call differentials in cat 1. So it's exactly the same in cat 3 for multiple three dimensions. So let's look at the example for these differentials. How much the value of f of x, y, and t y sine x plus 2 times y and g will change if point P dot moved 0.1 unit from P dot 0.10 threshold. So I like to measure how much the value changes df, right? The gradient of f at p dot to u direction with how much we change ds. This is what we want to find here. So the question is how we choose the value, how we corresponding, you know, finding the, you know, the exact value in the formula from the equation, from the problem. So this is very clear, the liquid is given, right? So we can find the gradient of this and then plug in my point. Question is, what is this one? What is this, right? So u is given because we have a straight motion. We follow in the straight line from 0.10 to 2.2 - 2. So we can find the direction. So let's get the direction. P dot P vector will be P dot P1 will be 2 - 0, 2 - 1 - 2 - 0, right? So it will be given by 2, 1, - 2. So this is not unit vector. So to calculate directional derivative, directional derivative, we have to know my unit vector. So let's call this is my unit vectors. So we know the direction, but again, in the different, in the directional derivative here, so u must be a unit vector, right? We did last time, correct? In the previous test, finding directional derivative. So we have to convert this one to the unit vector. So let's find the length of the v. What's the length of the V? Square root 4, 1, 4 is 9, nice, 2, 1, minus 2. In other words, we have 1 third times 2, 1, minus 2. This is my unit vector in the direction. And then, let's calculate our gradient f. Gradient of f, let's look at it. So y cosine x, comma, sine x, plus 2g, comma, 2y. That's my gradient. And then we have to find the gradient at given p dot 0, 1, 0. So, gradient of f at 0, 1, 0 will be plugging x equal to 0, y equal to 1. So we have 1 times cosine 0, comma, sine 0, plus 2 times 0, and 2 times 1, right? So it will be 1, comma, 0, comma, 2. That's my gradient. So let's calculate our fractional derivative now. So gradient of f, f p dot times u vector, it's my fractional derivative. It's given by 1, 0, 2 times 1 third, 2, 1 minus 2. This is my fractional derivative. So 1 third goes front, then we just calculate the vector dot product. So 2 plus 0 minus 4, so we have a minus 2 over 3. That's my fractional derivative. So what we did, now I finish this part. Right? So let's write down. So this will be number one, finding fractional derivative. Number two, let's know what ds. So how much we moved by? How much we moved?
1.1.
This is my ds. So number three, now we plug in how y value, f value changes, we call df, will be given by my gradient of f, fp dot, u vector direction, times ds. It will be given by minus 2 over 3, which is my gradient, my directional, times 0.1. So this is how much they change. How was it?
Good.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
Not there. Not there.
And then let's move to linearization. You guys remember what linearization in Cal 1? Linearize? Who was your instructor?
Linearization.
Pat Patterson.
You didn't learn linearization?
That's a dumb one.
What about you guys?
No, I don't.
Who is in South Carolina?
Who is your instructor? This side?
Yeah, we learned it in detail.
So what was the linear relation?
I can't remember. Oh, shit. I mean, if I see it, I know it, but I can't remember that.
This is Cantor's exercise. You guys are supposed to know what differential is, right?
I know no? It is, but if I saw it,
I'm going to throw
a holy moly, man.
Yeah.
That was Ms. Patterson. We were working on a problem on the boy. Come on, he wanted to help us.
I don't have a time to do
it for the TKO, come on.
So let's remove the...
Remember?
You might got quiet.
Linearization. So the linearization in Cal 1 is exactly the same as tangent line. Okay? 2D.
Like approximating stuff?
Yes, it is. So again, linearization, Cal 1, same as finding tangent line. Okay? Linearization in Cal 3 is same as finding tangent. Tangent?
Line.
Line. We are doing 3D. Tangent, right?
Plane. And plane. Okay.
Jack is same as finding tangent.
So definition, the linearization for fxy at x dot y dot is given by fxy, okay, f of x dot y dot plus f of x derivative p dot at x dot y dot, let's say p, so this is my p, and x minus x dot plus f of y and p y minus y dot. So this one we call linearization or approximation. So what does that mean? My f of x y can be approximated by L of x, y around P point. So this is linearization.
Is that negative?
What is negative?
Outside of the line.
No, it's not negative. Let's start. This one?
No, right there. Oh, keep going. Keep going.
Right there. This one?
Yeah.
Product. Let's take them. You guys know why we studied the linearization or approximation?
To get close to certain numbers.
Exactly.
Like
right.
Like a limit.
Yeah,
like
a limit. Yeah, you said it.
Exactly. So if I like to have a curve in the Cal 1, right? So I have a choose some number here, let's say x star, right?
Oh, snap. Hey.
The sun is up.
Young ladies. So x star, then I like to see what's going on in this part, right? So let's zoom in this page. Okay, come my zoom, then this one looks like straight line. Alright, this is my L of x. So y equal to f of x, right, can be approximated at L of x at x equal to x star. This is why we look at the linearization or approximation. I like to see zoom in. Right? And then see what behavior around x equal to x star. Then see what's going on. This is a linearization. So all the mechanism, like algorithm itself, no matter what you have, device, and you zoom in, right? Yeah. We apply this algorithm. Okay? Question about linearization. Is that okay? So in 3D, you have a surface, right? I like to see specific part, what's going on, the surface. I like to zoom in, right?
Yeah.
Then the question is, okay, how we zoom in? Then this one can be approximated by this one.
I thought we used the derivative to zoom in.
Yeah, this is derivative.
That's missing the derivative.
Oh, okay.
That's partial derivative.
Oh, okay.
Still. Yeah. Hey, bro. The derivative is zoom in. So that's why.
Integrating
like a global pattern.
Wait, I thought that's how you
zoom out.
Okay.
I like to zoom out. Everything can integrate. See. So let me raise this point. So this is the goal why we study, you know, linearization. Mm-hmm. Holy stops. Example number 4. Let's get the linearization of the function. So f is given by x squared minus xy plus 1 over 2 y squared plus 3. We have to find the linearization at 3.2. So, first we have to find the gradient, always. Gradient in terms of, you know, its partial derivative. So let's get 2x minus y and minus x plus y. This is my gradient, right? This is fx, fy. Then we plug in 3.2. So gradient of f at 3.2 will give my 6 minus 2 minus 3 plus 2. Will it be 4 minus 1. So this is my gradient vector, or fx and fy. And I'm going to use my linear approximation xy. Again, this will be f of x dot y dot. So let's calculate this one, f of 3.2. We know how to calculate, that's equal to y to 2. And plus my gradient, which is 4 times x minus 3 minus 1 times y minus 2. This is my linear approximation. So now let's calculate this number. So f of 3.2 will be what? 9 minus 6 and will be 4 and 2 plus 3 plus 2x minus 12 minus y plus 2. So let's simplify. We have 4x minus y and the constant minus 1, 8, minus 4, minus 2. So this is my linear approximation. Question?
You seem to question this, right?
Yeah. How was it? Is this okay?
So this is technically linearization using the partial derivative?
Is that again what?
This is linearization using the partial derivative?
Yeah, it's partial derivative we use. Gradient is partial derivative.
No, I know, but like, is this just the first part of the problem, or like, because I thought it was like approximation or something.
This is approximation. So what this means? So we have a 3.2, right?
Uh-huh.
So I like to measure what g value of, right? If I have some perturbation, like can you find corresponding g value? 3.001 minus, I'm sorry, 1.998. Look at that. I have a number, right? Point. I like to find g value. Right, corresponding g value.
Okay.
So, but this point is very close to this point, right?
Yes.
Then rather than plugging this one to original function, plugging this value to, you know, linear function, we must have almost the same point value.
Okay.
This so is the goal. Yes.
If we get a problem like that, we would have two things like that. We would have like the 3.2, and then we would have like a 3.001. No, I'm saying like if we got a problem like this, where we get like two points, like one for the ending and then one to begin with, or
what to mean, one to the ending, one to the beginning.
No, I'm saying are we gonna have to come up with our own point that's close to that point, to the original?
Yeah, this is the linear approximation. Yeah. If the point is very far away from the point, my linear approximation phase doesn't work because I draft here in, you know, cal one. We have a point here. Let's say this is a one, right?
Mm-hmm.
I find my linear approximation here. It's similar to this straight line, correct?
Yes.
But if I so my point should be like 1.2001. Then this point should follow the pattern of this one because they are close to each other.
Okay.
But if I choose like let's say 0.5 here, this point is very far away from one.
Yeah.
So this one. It's not the shape of this straight line. We have a different pattern. So we cannot use our linear approximation. So again, linear approximation is zooming. Then see local behavior.
This is linear approximation. Mm. If your point is not this area, right? It's very far away. This linear approximation doesn't work. You have to find another linear approximation around here. Mm. This is like zooming, right? If you like a zooming another part, right? You have a different function. Mm. Is that way? Does that work? Mm. Yeah. This is, you know, why we started this one again. That makes sense?
Yes.
Good. So now let's move to real problem, like differentials. So this is like appetizer before we do differentials. So now we have a very important concept in applied mathematics called differentials. Differentials. I will ask you a problem in here. So if we move point from star y dot to a point x dot plus dx, okay, y dot plus dy, small amount in x, y direction, the resultant change df will be given by f of x times dx, f of y times dy. This is we call differentials. So in Cal 1, differentials was, if you have y equal to f of x, right? Differentials was dy equal to f prime of x times dx. So since we only have one direction in x direction, right? But if you have two directions in x and y, then we have to have two different partial derivatives with different amount of the movement. What does that mean? Look at that. I have here x dot, y dot, right? So I like to move my point a little bit up. So this is dx and dy. So my new point will be x dot plus dx, y dot plus dy. So I change my point from here to here. So I made a large picture here, but if I choose very small delta x, dx, and dy, very small movement, I'd like to see how this one affects to the my output function. So you will see the example.
What's an example of, like,
I will show you.
No, moving the dot. Like, what's the purpose of moving it?
Huh?
What's the purpose of moving a dot? Like, an example.
I will show you. Example. Or 5. So suppose that a cylindrical can is designed to have a radius of 1 inch and a height of 5 inch, but the radius and height are off by amount dr 0.03 dh minus 0.1. The question is, estimate
the teacher thing change in one So this is like a real world problem. So you are hired in the Coca-Cola company, okay, or Pepsi company. So you have to design a can, right? But when you design the can, you have to save your money though, the material. How we save our material? Look at that. So we have a certain can, cylindrical can, right? This one. So we have something radius. And bottom, and we sort of have a height. Correct? So we can measure the volume. Again, it depends on the materials, the cost depends on the volume of the can, right? If the volume is small, then we save our materials, right?
Why?
If the volume is large, then we lose more materials, right? Because we have to put more materials inside. My material is just like soda. So let's look at this one. So, what we did, we have radius is 1 inch. That's my original one, the previous designed can, okay? We have a 5 inch in the height, right? That was my previous version, okay? Then, I'd like to change the radius by 0.03, and then reduce the height by 0.1, right? From my original version. The question is, if I do this one, then what my volume changes, how the volume changes, volume increase or decrease? We like to see decrease, right, to save money, correct?
Right.
So this is our goal. Does that make sense? So in this case, we use the differentials. Do you understand how we change the point? That point to point here, I like to change how in different direction, like radius and height, will be x and y, will be radius and height, can be, right? So I'd like to see if I change my radius and height, how this will affect to the volume of the can. So now let's look at volume function with pi r square, which is the base area of the circle, right? Times height. That's the volume equation. So how many variables we have? We have r and h, right? Correct? R and H. We had X and Y before.